So please. I have a feeling I'm going to be battling with this music stand all night, so. Well, my name is Dara Tucker, and I want to thank you all so much for coming out to Watermelon Wednesdays at West Whately Chapel. That's quite a mouthful. Whately, I'm so sorry. Greg told me it was Whately, and we sort of had a bad deal for that. So I'm so glad to see your smiling faces this evening. And we're so glad to be in such a beautiful part of the country that I didn't even know existed. I'm like, we have trouble getting folks out for jazz gigs in Nashville, and you guys are coming out to wherever it is. It's so gorgeous out here. It's just gorgeous. And, yeah, it's beautiful. So we're so glad to be here this afternoon. It's such a beautiful June day. I want to introduce you really quickly to the band. This is my first time playing with this young man. I sound like a true old person right now. This talented young man, Mr. Carl Moritz, on the drums. This from New York by way of Philly, Philadelphia. We have Mr. Greg Bryant, people from The Watchmen, on this guitar. So thrilled to be playing with this young man once again, Mr. Joe Davidian. I call him Mad Dog Joe Davidian. Joe actually used to live in Nashville, and he recently just moved away. That's where I'm from. I guess I didn't say that, but I'm living and performing in Nashville, Tennessee right now. Joe just moved away probably 7 months ago, something like that. It's been 8 years ago. Yeah, so we picked him up in New York and dragged him up here. So glad to have Joe with us once again. So you're gonna hear a collection this evening of my original music. And I went and looked at the series online, and it was mostly bluegrass music. And I thought, what in the world am I doing here? So I hope you all enjoy what you hear, and we're gonna give it to you the best that we can. So this next one is called Mother's Child, obviously written for my mom, Linda Tucker.
Speak gently with a smile, the reason.
Well, thank you all. Well, I want to do a song for you that I actually got in a dream, and it's found on the current Oklahoma Rain CD. We just put out the CD in late April. So I'm really excited to be bringing some of those songs to you. Obviously, the first song that we did tonight was the title track of Oklahoma Rain. So this one I got in a dream, and I have a kind of unique songwriting process. Sometimes I'll put together different parts of songs that I write over the years. So sometimes it takes me forever to write a song. So now, having written for about the last 10 years, it's starting to catch up, and I've accumulated, you know, a nice big pile of them. I don't have enough albums to put them on at this point. But with this particular song, I got in a dream, got the first part of it in a dream. I actually heard a couple of musician friends of ours playing it on the saxophone and the clarinet. So I just kind of held on to it for a while. I actually remembered it and, you know, sang it in my little voice recorder. Maybe 10 years later, I got the other part of it. And they sort of matched up very nicely, and then I put words to it and decided to include it on this project. So it's a little bit different from anything else I do. It's sort of a lullaby, and it's called Anytime Your Heart Breaks. Thank you. much. Well, I grew up with a lot of the singer-songwriters of the 1960s and 70s. It's one of my favorite eras in American music, so I want to do a song that sort of is my contribution to that particular genre of songwriting. This one's called The Penny.
Treasure that is hard to hold.
name.
I like them all, though.
Thank you.
As Mr. Paul explained in the intro, I had the opportunity a couple of years ago to appear on the Tavis Smiley Show. And when you have an opportunity to be heard by a national audience and you get one chance to do one song, oh, but there's so much more I do, and I can do this and this and this, but there's one opportunity to say, this is what I'm about, this is who I am, this is where I'm coming from. So I chose this particular song to sing on that show. I'll do it for you now. It was included on my last project, The Sun Season, which is here tonight. And this is one of the only songs, I think the only song that I've ever co-written. And I had my sister help me with the bridge. Her name is Diamond, and she's a graduate student at Roosevelt University. Greg has to help me with these things. My senior brain is starting to set everything. Yeah, my sister Diamond helped me to write this one, and it's called Giants.
Oh,
very much. Well, we are going to wrap up the first set with this next song, and I'll ask you to excuse us while we make just a little bit more noise than we have been for the rest of the evening, but we'll try and keep it down to a low roar, if at all possible. But once again, we want to thank you all for coming out this evening. We are super enjoying ourselves and always enjoy playing before very attentive listening audiences, and Paul, you have done a wonderful job in your staff in cultivating a listening environment. So thank you. And congratulations to yourselves. Thank you all. I want to reintroduce you to the band one more time this evening. This is Mr. Carl Moritz on drums. Song a little bit of why I call him the Mad Dog. And of course, my name is Dara Tucker. I want to remind you all that we will have CDs available at the stand here in the lobby in between the sets. This one's called Standing Alone.
Yeah.
to set number two with the Dara Tucker Band. I'm going to reintroduce the band to you very quickly. Maybe you got the chance to speak to a couple of band members over the set break. Mr. Carl Morris on drums. On bass, we have Mr. Greg, the Watchman Bryant. And on keyboard tonight, we have Joe Mad Dog Davidian. I'm Dara Tucker. Every once in a while, we like to. Thank you. Every once in a while, I like to pull out some surprises and do some music that is not found on any albums or anything. I write voraciously if I'm not in the midst of producing an album or promoting the album. So I'm happy to be getting back into the songwriting process. So I'll do one for you now that is one of the newer songs that I do, and hopefully will be included on the next project. This one's called "Call Your Name." Harmony. And I like to say we light them on track, children. So that's where I got my training. I did not go to any kind of music conservatory. I'm so admiring of people who have the stamina and the knowledge and the brilliance for that. I am not one of those people. So I got what I got in church, watching my mama and my daddy, Dara and Linda Tucker. And so he taught us all to sing from a really early age. My mom got my two older sisters, and I am number three, the two older sisters. And she got us together when we were four, five, and seven, and taught us a little song called God is So Good in three-part harmony, and she brought us to our dad. Most people think our dad taught us how to sing. This was our mom that kind of started us singing together. She brought us to him and said, look what the girls are doing now. So he flipped out and took us to church, and from that point on, we were his little choir. So we would sing songs by ourselves, we would sing songs and back him up. He would drive us around. His mother was a pastor, so he would drive us around to her various churches out in the country, in the sticks in Oklahoma, and we would sing three-part harmony together and for the worship services that he would conduct. So that was kind of my early training, and that's kind of a family business is what it really is. All my, you know, he has 15 brothers and sisters, and the majority. Yeah. give you a moment to take that in. So the majority of them are either preachers or pastors or musicians, songwriters, singers. So that's what I was steeped in. So because I come from such a large family, sometimes during the holidays it can be really difficult to give meaningful gifts. 35 nieces and nephews. Last time I counted, and it may have actually gone up since the last time I actually sat on the count. So you can imagine what Christmas time is like. It's pandemonium. It's crazy. We rarely get gifts for each other. So I had an idea one year to start a tradition within our nuclear family of close to 50 people that we would start giving songs to each other instead of trying to exchange gifts. We would exchange songs because that was something that would actually last and would be meaningful. So I would pick a theme every year. I do pick a theme every year, and we write for that theme. So one year, a few years ago, we got together at Thanksgiving instead of Christmas, and we did Christmas with the in-laws. We got together for Thanksgiving this year. So the natural theme would be thanks. So I'm going to sing now for you my offering for, I think this would have been Thanksgiving of 2013. And this is the one that I wrote as a gift to my family, and it's called The Morning Sun.
Thank you.
I used to tell my dad, I actually lost both my parents a couple of years ago in the same year, so it was one of those sort of life-altering experiences that really shakes the foundation of a lot that you feel and believe and think, and I worked through that whole process with songwriting. And if you're a creative person, then you understand the place that art has in helping you work through the good, the bad, and the ugly of life. So I'm super thankful to have had a tool like songwriting to help me to kind of walk through this very difficult process over the last couple of years. So I'll do one now. It's actually a brand new song. It's not found on Oklahoma Rain. But it's the newest one that I've written, and it's about my dad. And I used to tell him that he needed to be he should have been a wizard. He should have been Gandalf, because he was very wise, first of all. But then he also had no concept of time and how time affected, relationships, how time affected anything. He forgot about birthdays. They would come up on him, though they came at the same time every year. I would tell him that he tripped over birthdays, he tripped over Christmas, he was never quite ready for anything. Was a very loving dad, made no mistake, but he was one of those that really never quite got his brain around the effect of time and the fact that that was very much a limited thing and that we had only a certain amount of time to make things count. So he would always ask us, babies, give me 90 more days, give me 90 days, give me 180 days. I don't know if you ever heard him say that, Greg. He was known for that. He was very much known for that. We would imitate him all the time. Babies. He spoke like Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh. Babies, give me 90 days. So we would make fun of him all the time because he was never great with time. So this is from my dad, Doyle Tucker. It's called Time.
You were never the best with time.
so much once again for coming out this evening. Being such a wonderfully attentive audience, Joe, I'm sorry. This is what it's going to be for just a minute. For being such a wonderfully attentive audience and supporting all kinds of great music. They were telling me over the set break that you all were having all kinds of eclectic configurations coming through this summer. So it's so wonderful to see a place where music and the arts are celebrated. Lord knows that that is under threat these days and not being valued as it should be. So I just want to tip my hat, my proverbial hat, to you all. Greg, can you tickle my hat? There you go. For your celebration of the arts and your support of the arts and of the Dara Tucker Band. So we are just thrilled as we can possibly be to have been a part of this series. Thank you to Mr. Paul for having us. Ms. Claudia, for your support staff. And I'm just so impressed. I'm an amateur kind of documentary filmmaker myself. I'm always impressed when I see these wonderful professional setups, and I've gone and watched many of the much of the footage that's online. So you all are doing a wonderful job of documenting the series so that the world outside of West Whately. And I'm so proud of Paul when he got my name right. Most people say Dara. He said Dara the first time, so I'm super impressed. So I've got to get the name of the town right. Whately, West Whately. So that the folks outside of West Whately can see what's going on in West Whately. And it's really exciting, and more power to you. Keep it up, stay encouraged, and we'll be watching. We will be watching. We'd love to do this at some point again in the future. Thank you all so much. Want to introduce you once more to the band, Mr. Carl Moritz on drums. CD's out in the foyer, as you know. I was asked in the break whether I do any gospel, and I usually try to sneak in a number or two. Sometimes I don't even tell the band what's coming. So this would be one of those nights that I was reminded that it's okay. I told you my grandmother was a Pentecostal pastor. I don't know if you know much about the Pentecostal church. Those are some wild folks. So we're not going to be rolling in the aisles this evening, but I'm going to give you a little taste of where I come from. Thank you all so much for having us. We hope to see you again really soon. Thank you so much.
Just a closer walk with me. Thank you.
Greg wants to do beautiful songs, so it'll be beautiful songs. Thank you all so much. They said back there that West Whately Chapel has not heard that kind of raucous, I guess.
Sunday.